if you want to feel better about your health and you want to feel like a really in shape, healthy person, even if you're not, go on a cruise ship for a week. A lot of drinkers and eaters on those ships. It'll drink and eat you into feeling great. Wow. I had never been on a cruise ship, ever. And Lewis Black booked a comedy cruise and made me go. And I got to Miami, I'd never even seen a cruise ship up close. They're humongous. It holds 4,000 people. It's gigantic. My sister goes, what was it like? Maybe me and Matt will go. I go, here's what it was like. Picture if we were all in Las Vegas, standing in the Bellagio, and all of a sudden, it just sailed away. The whole building, and nobody panicked or acted weird. I see ya, bye. Hey, want to try a monkey ass rum punch? Yes, I love monkey ass rum punch. 7 monkey rum punches later, you hear, and now we will be doing the safety drill. What? What? I'm hammered. I can't do a safety drill. It is on your muster station, which is located on the back of your key card. It will not match your deck or room, so please pay. What?
Now there's math involved? This is a terrible vacation. There's no math on vacation.
I finally found my room, and I was next to these lovely people from Wisconsin, and they had balloons all over their door. And I was like, oh, hey, is it somebody's birthday or anniversary? And the guy goes, no. We just get so hammered on the ship and these rooms all look alike. So we decorate our door. And the good news for you, sweetheart, is every time you find this door, you got a 50-50 chance of finding your room. Yes, I do, Mr. Milwaukee. You are my new best friend. Don't tell me alcoholics are lazy. Look at that energy. He had to get tape, balloons. He had to stop smoking for 4 seconds to blow them up. There's a lot of activities. Oh, yeah. You get on the ship, and there's this giant neon board. It looks like a Vegas sports betting board. You're like, oh, it's still overwhelming. You're like, oh, that looks fun. That looks fun. Well, if you're a sleeper-inner or a drinker-later, you will not be involved in any of these activities because these will require you to be up at 6 a.m. with a fanny pack on, ready to jump in some dinghy with your new friends from Buffalo. And, because my friend Shay wanted to do it all. I'm like, no, I am not getting up at 6 a.m. to go to Stingray Village. I don't have it in me. If someone puts the stingrays in my bathtub, I will pet them, but I am not, I'm not doing that. I don't care enough. Her and her husband Mike, they did every activity. You sure? And she checked back in. You sure, Kathleen? Tomorrow we're gonna zip line through the Mexican jungle. Yeah? I'm sure. There is nothing I could think of that would make me projectile vomit more quickly than to be hot and hungover and shot through a Mexican jungle on a rubber band. No. No, I'm good. I am good right here on this chair with my monkey-ass rum punch. And you know what? You call me crazy, Shay, but I question the safety of that apparatus. I truly do. They make you sign a form. Really? What form? Who made those up? Juan and Julio in the van that won't be there when you come back with your flesh-eating bacteria wound that there's no hospital around. Hope you have a good time with the ship, doctor, getting your bacteria-eaten leg fixed up. If you're a drinker or a sleeper-inner, your activity adventure will consist of getting off that ship at about noon into some sad little Mexican town where you're gonna hear a guy in an alley go, psst. And you don't know why, but you're gonna go over to that guy. Because you wanna hear what he has to offer. And you're gonna go over there, and he's gonna show you a clipboard with pictures of pretty fish, and he's gonna tell you he can take you to snorkel in there for $20. And you're gonna say 10. You don't know why he even said that. And then he's gonna say 15, And the next thing you know, you're going to be on a rickety-ass Partridge Family bus going to Christ knows where. Because that's when Lou got the maddest he's ever been at me, because we were the only two that agreed to this adventure. He was like, this is stupid. This is the stupidest thing you've ever taught me into. We don't know who the fuck that man is. We don't know where this bus is really going. I said, I know, Lou. That's why this is a real adventure. Those people on that Royal Caribbean ship know exactly what time they're coming back tonight. We may never come back tonight, Luke. Do you understand the level of excitement I have provided for $15 a man? Come on. The worst thing about a cruise ship, though, is they have a TV channel on your little boat channel. And in the afternoons, when I first turned it on, it's a picture of where you are in the ocean, because there's cameras on the outside of the boat. You go, oh, isn't that lovely? And it's just the sea and nice spa music. But in the morning, no. When you turn that channel on, it's not the lovely ocean with spa music. It's a picture of your bill from the day before. Right. Oh, how mean is that? What kind of buzzkill is that? This is vacation. I don't need to review my bad behavior on a daily basis. What kind of sadist is running this ship? That is horrible. All that can wait till sad Sunday when it's checkout time. And I see the bill, and I go, oh my God. And then I become alarmed, and I have that conversation that I seem to have with myself about once a year when I see it on paper. I go, holy Jesus Christ. I think you're an alcoholic.
Hey, shh. Hey, it was vacation. Wow, you bought drinks for those nice people from Buffalo. The drinks were overpriced.
I think you need to take that alcoholic test online.
Don't you dare. Don't you dare. It's all true or false. You've never done well on true and false. You always guess wrong. They don't let you explain anything. The world is black and white to those people. The world is not a black and white place. The world has gray areas. Question number four, example. Do you drink at home alone? True. However, I used to go out and drink with my friends at bars, and then they said I couldn't drink and drive. So now I stay home sometimes and drink and watch Shark Week. So, am I an alcoholic or am I just a really good citizen who loves America?